Alright, the concept is, what'll happen if I try to draw using almost strictly my sense of touch, and I deprive all of the other senses? Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put myself in a box, put in some earplugs, tape off all the light leaks, and have a snorkel to breathe through, go into some art supplies, a towel to lay down on, and a bottle of water for an hour, and then I'm going to see what I come out with. These are the boxes I'm going to be using to make my tank slash tomb. Got some cardboard, got a snorkel so I can breathe. Nice cheapie from Walmart. It's really pretty too. I'm going to have to keep that. As you can see, this box isn't very big. About big enough that I can lay down in it and flip on my side if I need to. That's about it. Now, this is going to be my tomb right here. Pretty good size, I fit in it, and it's like maybe 6 inches at the end of my feet, so that's good. It's still really small. This is my breathing apparatus. It's the 997 snorkel at Walmart. Here I have my earplugs, make everything just white noise, so I'm not interrupted by sound. And I'm in good hands, because as you can see, they're trusted since 1992. This is my faithful assistant Josh buying snacks so he doesn't die of boredom. That's something to do while he stands there and looks at me. He's gonna knock like every 10 minutes to make sure I haven't died. Alright, I have the inside paneled and I have my scuba snorkel in there so I can breathe. Now I have what I'm going in with is a towel for a pillow, bottle of water, and some art supplies. The kicker is, I'm not going to be able to see, so the colors are probably going to be really cool. This is what it feels like to be entombed, right here. Yeah, there's none. I'm going to have my faithful assistant box me up when we go out for it. But yeah, this is comfortable.
Now he's been in there for about 15 minutes. This is Max Wheeler, second shift, Ryan, box watch. Don't know how to use the camera very well, so bear with me. Ryan has now reached the half an hour point in his box extravaganza. Oh yeah. It's now 5:15, the 40 minute mark. Let's make sure he's okay. And he is good. Alright, it's 5:25 now, it's at the 50 minute mark. Ryan Hurdle is still trapped in a box. Let's make sure he's okay. Alright, he's fine. I have 5:35, time to get him out of there.
Dog.
Oh my god, it's good.
Oh, you're so sweaty. Oh, birthday wishes do come true. Merry Christmas, Max.
Oh. The hell's the zoom on this?
This is art, baby. This is art, right here.
Why are you taping this?
You told me to.
Why wouldn't I tape this? I feel like I had to vomit, like, the fourth time you tapped or whatever. Like, I'm sucking up the tube, and, like, it just felt like, ugh. Oh, I would have been mad if you would have vomited through the colors. It's not as bad as I thought it would be. I pictured you just coming out all black, but I swallowed a piece of pastel. I want to see what everything looks like.
Ryan Hurdle hates that box so much. He lived inside of it for an hour and came out with pink underwear. Which is funny because
when it went in a tux,
came out in pink underwear. Ryan Hurdle is so delirious right now, he has no idea what's going on.
I'm so done with this. Yeah, this is what happened.
And I felt restless and I felt soft. I didn't know anymore who I was ripping off. And I packed a picnic lacking seriously on food. I had more wine than I knew what with to do. Just don't know what it is. I just don't know what it is to be free, to hold and have somebody lean on me. You can blame it on your teachers, you can blame it on the weather, you can blame it on how your mother and father didn't stick together. Someday, darling, it's got to make sense in your head.